The integration of artificial intelligence technology in retail and e-commerce is revolutionizing the industry, offering significant opportunities for growth, efficiency, and revenue generation. Welcome to VAR India News Hour. AI algorithms analyze customer behavior, purchase history, and preferences to provide personalized product recommendations. These enhances customer satisfaction and increases sales. AI-driven dynamic pricing adjusts prices in real time based on demand, competitive pricing, and other factors, optimizing revenue and profit margins. AI helps predict demand trends, enabling retailers to optimize inventory levels, reduce stock hours, and minimize excess inventory. AI can streamline supply chain operations by predicting delays, optimizing routes, and improving overall logistics management. AI-powered chatbots and virtual assistants provide 24/7 customer support, answering queries, assisting with purchases, and resolving issues promptly. AI analyzes customer feedback and interactions to provide valuable insights into customer preferences and areas for improvement. Secondly, AI enables customers to search for products using images, enhancing the shopping experience by allowing users to find items similar to a photo they have. AI-driven voice assistants like Amazon's Alexa and Google Assistant facilitate hands-free shopping, making the process more convenient and accessible. AI systems monitor transactions in real time, identifying and flagging suspicious activities to prevent fraud and ensure secure transactions. AI-driven security systems protect customer data and prevent cyber threats, enhancing the overall security of e-commerce platforms. The integration of AI technologies in retail and e-commerce is driving significant advancements and creating new opportunities for growth, efficiency, and revenue generation. By leveraging AI, retailers can enhance customer experiences, optimize operations, and make data-driven decisions, ultimately leading to increased revenue and a competitive edge in the market. Let's look into today's headlines. Meta presents an AI model that can handle challenging arithmetic issues. Meta Platforms has announced its latest Llama 3 AI models, including a major release with 405 billion parameters. This model approaches the performance of competitors like GPT-4 and Claude 3.5 Sonnet in multilingual communication and difficult math problem solving. To further improve its overall functionality and accuracy, the Llama 3 also has a larger context window and improved coding capability. Symphony AI and L&T Technology Services collaborate to offer AI-based business transformation. L&T Technology Services and Symphony AI have announced plans to provide businesses across the globe with disruptive AI operations. To increase efficiency, streamline tasks, and create enjoyable experiences for end users, analysts, and executives, the solutions are provided through Apex Enterprise Copilot and Symphony AI Apex Service Management, a predictive and generative AI-based ITSM/ESM platform. Smartphone prices to drop due to a customs duty reduction. A number of initiatives were unveiled by Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman to bolster India's electronics sector. This included a 20% reduction in basic customs duty on mobile phones, mobile printed circuit board assemblies, PCBAs, and mobile chargers, as well as a 15% increase in duty on PCBAs of certain telecom equipment. In order to ensure the availability of these materials for key industries like telecommunications, electronics, energy, space, defense, renewable energy, and nuclear energy, the budget also suggested reducing the basic duty of two of these materials and exempting 25 essential minerals and rare earth elements from custom duty. Government brings in three employment-linked incentive programs in the budget. The finance minister unveiled 3 new incentive programs in the union budget for 2024-2025 with the goal of boosting job growth in the formal and manufacturing sectors. These programs, which are a component of the PM's budget package, will be connected to the EPFO or Employee Provident Fund organization. They are intended to benefit both employees and employers and promote the employment of new hires. Government to build small end reactors by roping in the private sector. As India aims to achieve net zero carbon emissions by 2070, Union Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman has proposed roping in the private sector to boost the share of nuclear power in India's energy basket. Sitharaman announced in her budget that the government will partner with the private sector to set up Bharat small reactors and in the research and development of small molder reactors and for newer technologies for nuclear energy. That's all for now. Please like, share, comment and subscribe to VAR India Magazine. You can download the VAR India app from Google Play Store and Apple App Store for more news and updates. Stay tuned. Thank you.